Hello everyone, I am Dev. I am going to help you learning various web technologies like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, jQuery, PHP, MySQL and many more. Before jumping into writing programs, we shall understand various web related terms. Let's start from internet itself. So internet is nothing but a large group of computers connected with each other and use standard protocols to communicate. You must know the communication is made over a standard protocol that is known as HTTP. A web server is a computer that provides services to its clients. Client computer sends requests and server responds them back. As you can see, the server receives request from browser, process the request and then send response back to the browser. All communications over internet are made of zeros and ones or binaries. Web browsers convert it to human readable format. When you type gmail.com in your browser, it means you are requesting Gmail server to open your mailbox so that you can read your mails or send new mail. After getting requests, the Gmail server responds you back. Maybe ask for login ID or password. So simple, client machine request and server response. Most of the common examples are Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Internet Explorer and Apple Safari. For our tutorials, we are going to stick with Google Chrome and Mozilla Firefox. We will go deep into all technologies later, but for now, I am mentioning here what I am going to cover in our syllabus. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. Whatever you see in a web page is simple HTML. We will go in detail later. Then CSS stands for Cascading Style Sheet. It is used to give style or enhance the look and feel. You can set color of any element, can give space, margin, padding, or even manage fonts. For now, this is sufficient to know on CSS. JavaScript is a client-side scripting language and is used for form validations, animating something on the web page. Also, there are many things I have to say on JavaScript later. jQuery is a packaged library based on JavaScript. It provides powerful functionalities by writing less code. So write less and do more. You are going to love it soon. PHP is very popular nowadays. It stands for Personal Homepage or Pre-Hypertext Processor. It runs at server-side. Whereas PHP needs a web server. We will use Apache Server in our tutorial to run PHP codes. MySQL, a very popular open-source relational database management system that provides the facility to store, manipulate and retrieve data. It is really very powerful and we are going to cover maximum functionalities in later lessons. Finally, we are also going to study a PHP framework, which provides various powerful and standard features to write PHP code. PHP frameworks help us to make our projects modular and robust. We will discuss in detail later. First, what we are going to do is download a code editor so that we can write our codes. To start writing codes, we need IDEs. IDEs stands for Integrated Development Environment, in short, editor. Right now, a dozen of free and paid code editors are available on the market. You can choose any editor to write code, it's not going to be a problem at all. For our tutorial, I'm going to stick with Sublime Editor. It provides a lot of functionalities, consumes very low system resources and is lightning fast. I recommend you Sublime to write clean codes. Other IDEs available are Microsoft WebMetrix, NetBeans, Notepad++, Eclipse, Adobe Dreamweaver and Blueface. The best thing about Sublime Text is it can run on Windows, Mac and Linux. Now let's try to understand how the communication is made over the internet. How the communication occurs between a client and a server machine, let's understand it properly. Client machine sends requests to the server. Server may communicate database if required. Now server processes the output and ready to send it back to the client's browser. So it sends the output to the client machine. For example, user have typed gmail.com in his browser. Gmail browser responds him back and asks, hey, what's your login ID and password? Please log in first. This is the way it works. This is it for today. Tomorrow we will install all required softwares and start writing codes. Till then, bye-bye.